responsibility has me betrayed. Naked in a pool of wrath, this mother nature had some bad weed and started tripping. I can feel it, I can feel it, I can feel it.
Rick James influence. And you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Rick James from Buffalo, New York. These cats here from like New York City or something like that, man. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show, paying homage to the great Cameo. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. Once again, Tribute Tuesday, paying homage to the great Cameo. What's the dude's name? Larry Blackman. Wearing the big-ass red cup. That's some old freaky Rick James type stuff right there. You know, you wearing your cup outside of your pants for the last 25 years. That's some shit Rick James would do. Next to burning some chick in a closet as well. Shouts out to the great Cameo. Greatest wedding party starter song ever. Candy. Yes, sir. Hey, so... As we talked about yesterday, and I'm going to jump in the chat here in a second. We finish out today's show, man, just talking to the Stewies in the power hour, the third hour of the show. But I need to quickly mention, man, we mentioned this yesterday. We talked about this yesterday, but Andrew Bogut cleared waivers from the 76ers, and Jose Calderon cleared waivers from the Lakers. And so Bogut's probably going to sign with the Cleveland Cavaliers, and Calderon is probably going to sign with the Golden State Warriors. Yeah, now they're saying Bogut is going to speak to a couple of teams, but chances are it'll be Cleveland that he ultimately decides to go with, giving them more depth on the front line. But he's also going to talk to San Antonio, Houston, and Boston. See, but here's the thing. The way it's being sold to us now is that unless you're in the Cleveland Cavaliers or the Golden State Warriors, you really don't have much of a chance in winning or going to the championship. You see what I'm saying? So, yeah, I mean, San Antonio and Houston and Boston, you know, they would be good spots for him, and he would probably even get a lot more playing time and be able to compete more than he would in Cleveland. But the attitude today, man, in 2017 is we don't want to fight. We don't want to compete. We just want to stack the deck. So I'd be very surprised if Bogut went to the Spurs. And these are good teams. You know, maybe Bogut goes to Houston and, you know, that one piece that takes them over the top where they could beat Golden State. I doubt it. You know, or maybe he goes to San Antonio. San Antonio's had a lot of success. Maybe he goes to San Antonio, but chances are he's not going to do it. And you know, they like foreign players in San Antonio, so that might even be a better fit than anywhere else based on, you know, the Spurs' history with foreign players over the last decade or so under Popovich. But that's probably not going to happen. He's probably going to go to Cleveland because Cleveland's probably going to make it to the championship, and he just wants to get a ring. He wants to ride their coattails to get a ring. Same thing with Calderon. Same thing with Calderon. There's another couple of cats that, Brandon Jennings and Luis Scola also were waived Monday by the Knicks and the Brooklyn Nets. So Brandon Jennings can play. Brandon Jennings can ball. I don't know, man. They'll probably end up on the Cavs or the Warriors too. You know, maybe not those two teams because they're probably stacked. They're good to go right now. If they get Bogut and they get Calderon and the two examples I just gave, maybe Brandon Jennings probably goes to the next tier team that has a spot available. They'll, you know, maybe he goes to San Antonio or Houston or something like that. We'll see. But very interesting, man, the way the NBA works in 2017, very, very, very interesting, to say the least. From LD, Slice Ham from the D in the chat room on Spreaker.com. He says, Brady was a backup starter because of injury to Bledsoe. Yeah, but that's not the example that we gave, that I gave earlier that I was trying to find an answer to. That doesn't fall into that category either. I still haven't gotten one. The closest one that we've gotten, and it's not really even close, was the Steve Young one. But that doesn't even fit the bill either. From Sly, the sports guy, he sat behind Joe for years. You took too many hits to the head, Doug. No, I didn't. I did take a lot of hits to the head, but still, Steve Young doesn't fall under the conversation that we had originally, the question that I asked. Where you're a backup quarterback on a team, the starter gets hurt, you come into the game, flourish for two or three games, go to another organization as a free agent, a big free agent signing, in this example of Jimmy Garoppolo, and end up being a star. That's the example that I gave. None of these are that example. They're close. They kind of remind you of it, but they're not the same example. From High Class Trash, you know what it is, Doug. He has not won anything. Who's he talking about? Jimmy Garoppolo, maybe? From Big Apple Bastard, my Knicks doing a Texas tie, tanking, getting missing for Black History. What? I don't get that at all, man. From 334 Bama Boy, the chat room with Spreaker.com. He says, Andrew Bogut was a number one overall pick that averages about 9 points per game as a career. How the hell he gets these options? Never understood the infatuation with Andrew Bogut. I guess because he's a skilled, quote-unquote, skilled big man, which means that he can pass the ball. That's all that means. Whenever they say that about a center, and especially a foreign player, he's such a skilled big man. That means that they can pass the ball. I'm trying to think what else makes you into a quote-unquote skilled big man. Right. That just means that they're kind of smart as far as basketball IQ. They don't do a lot of dumb things. They don't do a lot of great things, and they can pass the ball. Right. I've never understood why it seems like Andrew Bogut is such this great commodity as far as, you know, the NBA. He hadn't really done a damn thing. Who do we have here? T-Dub in the chat room on Spreaker.com. Doug, Jennings suffered an Achilles injury last year, so he's not the same player that he was a few years ago. No, I didn't say he was the same player he was a few years ago. He's still a good player, and I do remember him having an Achilles injury or whatever. But you remember, when he came out of high school, I mean, matter of fact, didn't he skip college? Right, Brandon Jennings skipped college, went and played overseas for a year before he got into the NBA. From Al Thompson, the same reason players went to Miami Mocha to try to win a ring. Exactly. From Miss Mocha Bella, they say Joe Mixon was not invited to the combine. Yeah, I heard that story as well, read that story. They talked about that this morning on the Puppet Factory, how Joe Mixon and what's his face? Quarterback from Ole Miss. Kelly. The Kelly kid didn't get invites because of getting in trouble with the police off the field. From Rail, the intern, Scott Jennings can score. He doesn't want to play defense. From Sid, Ninja Fried Chicken Jackson. Well, last year people had penciled Golden State in to win the ring, but they didn't. Nothing is etched in stone. True, but I think it comes down to, if you're talking about a team representing each conference, the East and the West, I think it comes down to Cleveland in the Golden State. From DRD Hardy. What up, DRD Hardy? Nothing from Knights. If the sound table or camisole is pretty poor, tribute if you ask me. Nothing from Knights. If the sound table or camisoles, I don't know. Maybe he's talking about Cameo. From Rail the Intern, Scott, you play Candy at Black Wedding. Everybody and their mama getting up on that dance floor to do the electric slide. You better believe it. Ah, back to the Big Apple Bastard in the chat room on Spreaker.com. He says, Doug, how about getting a BPA for Texas Tie for getting missing on Black History Month with his punk ass? Laugh out loud. Hey, bro, you the last one need to be talking about Texas Tie and being someplace and, you know, being honorable or whatever. Long story short, if you're new to the Doug Stewart Show, I can't even believe you brought this back up, Big Apple Bastard. The nerve of you. The nerve of you. To make a long story short, for new people listening to the show, TDSS2, which I talked about earlier, Big Apple Bastard bet Texas Tie, who's a white guy that listens to the show, friend of the show, great guy, that he wouldn't come to TDSS2 and, as he put it, hang out with the black people. Not only did Texas Tie come to TDSS2, but he drove 14 hours to and fro from Texas with his fiance. Or maybe it was his wife at the time. I'm not exactly sure. That's neither here nor there. Not only did he come to Atlanta and hang out with all the Stewies and me for TDSS2, he came to all of the events. He's a great guy. They wagered paychecks on whether this would happen or not. Texas Tie